Okay, so here's exercise two. I just want to, I've placed my voice now with the lip drum, right? So now I just want to kick the diaphragm a little bit and free that up. I'm making the basic body sound. It's called UH. Okay? And I'm kicking the diaphragm. You can't really see it. So let me see if I can change this a little bit. I need something to hold it. I can hold down here. Okay. Alright. So, you have to kick. This part is a diaphragm, right? Well, that has to be engaged when you go into a tone, right? So, I want to bring air into my belly. And then I want to kick. And then I'll start going. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see it? And so that I don't lose control of the top part, I'm going to close my nostrils, but at the very bridge of the nostrils, so that it goes up and over. Okay, you can listen to that. Trying to do it as light as possible, yeah. Not to put any pressure on the vocal cords right now. You don't want to put any pressure ever, but there is some tension, you know, once you go up through the subject, okay? So that was not successful, so I'm going to do it again. And I'm going to stick my tongue out, right? And I'm going to depress my tongue just for a minute to get the space that I want. Maybe I'll change it and go into a hey, you know? I took the full voice up to the G for the tenor that's going through the passaggio, right? It's just to give me a little bit of oomph here. Now I'm going to mix it in with the falsetto and bring it down. And very, very light. And you almost want to feel like you're crying. The buzz that comes right here. if you just put air through the nose as you are holding your cheeks here close to your nostrils, I'll let you see that closer. So what happens is you get a frontal placement that is very easy to sing and makes it easier for the tone to ride on the breath. So let's start another one.